Cheers, family. I thought we would do a little walk and talk. Incredible news happening for all of us right now with the US dollar stablecoin running through the XRP ledger and the Ethereum ledger, or blockchain. But I wanted to have a quick conversation about the major bullish items that that we have to look forward to and why I believe XRP is going to be dramatically increased in value. And while we're walking and talking, I'm going to look for, it's a little early for blue crabs, but that's one of the number one reasons I moved here. I love crabbing. So I'll be keeping my eyes out for them as we walk. Signs of them crawling out of the mud for the winter. So the major things would be the ending of the SEC lawsuit. That's probably number one. That's going to take the boot off of the neck, or another visualization would be crimping a garden hose and then letting it go and allowing it to flow, if you will. That's going to come to an end. That has to come to an end. We're in April. Let's just say, worst case scenario, we're talking about the end of May, maybe. So by June, and if you guys, come on, we're all adults here. Look how fast time flies. If we're talking about by June 1st, we're looking at a jump up because of the SEC case ending. Okay. We're also talking about the Bitcoin halving and the way that Bitcoin tends to bring the entire crypto market with it. Okay, there's another one. We're looking at all the economic conditions around the world and major nations de-dollarizing and looking to move to CBDCs and cryptocurrency to facilitate money movement. That's exactly what Ripple does. We're looking at ISO 2020 or 220, which is boring, nerdy shit that basically has to do with banking policy and how money has to move around the world. Well, there's only so many cryptocurrencies right now that are already compliant, that are set to go. XRP leads the pack on that. So does Cardano. So does HBAR. Those are all ISO 2020 compliant tokens. Now we have US dollar stablecoin, an additional feature of the XRP ledger. This is not to replace XRP. This is addition, in addition to. Again, I'll go back to my Amazon example, that Amazon makes all of its money from its web hosting services. It also has a storefront. It also delivers groceries. It also streams movies, and so on and so forth. We're looking at, look at Ripple as a company. When they're adding something so substantial, there's a huge gap in terms of stablecoin, because I told you, there's really only two options at the moment, USDC and Tether. Why does that matter? What's the deal with a stablecoin? Because there's no risk. Because you can move money knowing that when it gets from point A to point B, it's going to be the same amount. It's a way to transmit money. That is extremely important. And it's extremely important that it stays stable. And there's not a lot of options. There's Tether, and I'm telling you now, Tether is bad news bears, okay? There's no transparency there. We're just supposed to trust you that you didn't mint coins out of thin air? Why can't we look at your books? I don't trust it. Not a dime of my portfolio is in Tether. So there's a gaping hole for a crypto to step up and fill that need. That's what Ripple just did. Huge. Now, lastly, tokenization. Don't let these words become buzzwords where they lose meaning, okay? So what does that mean? What is tokenization? The idea is, let's say there's a new hotel being put up in your town. Well, rather than traditionally seeking investors and bank loans and everything, that hotel can turn the hotel into a stock. Think of it that way. They'll divide it up into a million shares, tokens, crypto tokens. You can buy those tokens that will be worth more money later. You're a part owner of that hotel. Now expand that to literally fucking everything. Cars. Okay, here's one. back in the GameStop scenario, there was a group that purchased a one-of-a-kind unreleased Wu-Tang album that was originally bought by Martin Shkreli. Remember that, turd? Because he just wanted to have something exclusive. This group, now I can't think of the name of it, purchased that album with the idea, at least we believed at the time, and I don't know what their plans are now, they could split up that legendary one-of-a-kind Wu-Tang album into tokens. And by possessing those tokens, by buying them just like any other cryptocurrency, stored on your ledger, you now have a key to access a private club. You would be able to go listen to that album because you're one of its owners. You can prove that you're one of its owners. Houses, cars, businesses, everything of value digitalized and put on a blockchain, able to be traded like stock, like crypto, like baseball cards. I could trade you directly. I could say, hey, you know what? I've got 100 coins worth of that house in Alabama. You trade me for 50 coins of that hotel over there. It's going to be a fun way to build a portfolio. But those coins have to go across a ledger. That's what Ripple does. That's what Ripple's offering. The more flows across our ledger, the more value that ledger has. And the way that that ledger facilitates and operates is through XRP. XRP value must go up. 1 + 1 must equal 2. So let me recap. Why are you going to be rich? Because you're holding a coin that is now, there's no arguing that it's not top three. Big three. Bitcoin, Ethereum, XRP. Are Bitcoin and Ethereum 50 cents? Of course not. They weren't kneecapped, but that's ending. You're owning the big three that have solidified themselves, that are the household brands. SEC case ending, Bitcoin halving, and the crypto bull run. Money escaping into crypto because of economic conditions, because of black swan events, because of WW Trace. I pray to God that doesn't happen, but I don't see how it can. You poke a bear long enough, the bear pokes back. Tokenization, all that, trillions of dollars. Oh, and a very good point. Oh God, I can't think of your username right now, but you have the Punisher logo. He brought up an excellent point about us getting an ISDA agreement, an ISDA license. If you remember the movie The Big Short, an ISDA license allows you to trade in derivatives and big dick investments that you and I don't have access to. Ripple does, and now those investments get to move across that ledger. Lou was very excited about this because it's trillions of dollars. So we've got trillions coming in from derivatives. We've got trillions now poised to come in from our stablecoin. We've got trillions coming in because of tokenization, all running through the XRP ledger. All of that traffic will increase the value of XRP. Boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, it's a once-in-a-lifetime investment. God, I love it here. All right. I got my my kids down there. I brought a dip net with me. Water's still a little bit chilly. It's 77 today. Gorgeous breeze. 77, sunny. And, you know, we're touching into the 80s this week. So summer's already rolling out. Crabs will be out soon. This is all I ever wanted in life. I want to refinish furniture I find at thrift stores and make it cool and sell it as pieces of art. And I want to catch crabs out of the water. And clap my wife's cheeks from time to time. I'm a simple man. Cheers, y'all. You're going to be rich.
All right.
Quick video, guys. I'll talk to you in a little bit.